Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is the Sound Patterns Puzzle. Sound Patterns is a tribute to the work of Kagan Sound. For those of you who know him, always see his mesmerizing patterns in some of his puzzles, where the object is to make these nice patterns. And so far he has made the patterns typically on a flat thing, either sliding or rotating, and I thought let's do the same concept in on a cylinder. So the object of this puzzle, it's a pattern puzzle. So you can turn the little circles, and the object is to make patterns like what you see here. So all the rings, they are the same, and when they are straight above each other, then you get this sound pattern. And when they are off by only one step, then you get this sound pattern. And anyway, since the rings have sevenfold, sort of symmetry, you can make seven sound patterns, and for each pattern, rings are stacked on top of each other with a turning of a similar angle. So let me show you a little bit more about the prototyping that has been taking place. First of all, what you see here is one of these rings, and all of the rings are identical, and they have the black pattern on it, like this. Also, there's a little knob in the middle. I don't know whether you can see it, but also that knob is always at the same place. So for the first sound pattern, you need to get the knobs all aligned in the same direction, like this. For the second, they go one step turned. And this is challenging because, we have at the inside. Okay, let me just assemble. At the inside, we have these patterns. And you see the little notches. And you can place the ring only at the place where there's a notch. So when you try to solve it and you start from bottom to top, you can place the ring at this place and at that place, but not at this place, then it doesn't go down. So this makes this puzzle a real challenge. When I prototyped, first I tried to do the puzzle in a single color. But a single color doesn't really look nice because the contrast is not that good. So the single color prototypes were a failure. Since I have a very simple printer, I could only print one color at a time. So I used glue to glue in the black into yellow. It looks already a bit better, but still not very good. And then I met my friend Steve Nichols, and he said, "Hey, I do have a 3D printer with double nozzles. So when you have two nozzles, then you can print black and white, black and yellow at the same time. So every time it switches between nozzles. So this looks much better. And actually, I would be very interested if there are other puzzles that could also be made with a dual nozzle printer, where you really need the dual nozzles. However, that's not my question for you today. My question is about the design of this puzzle. I took a lot of effort to minimize the number of notches such to make the puzzle as difficult as possible. So actually, the design that I found, there's only one solution to have them all straight, so where you have the notches in a line. There is only one solution where you have them spiraling around, like the sound pattern that I had shown to you before. And all these other sound patterns also, they only have a single solution. And my question to you is, what is that minimum number of notches, and how do you design this puzzle to minimize the number of notches? Thank you for watching.